Let's try a couple of examples to determine algebraically whether each function is even, odd, or neither. So we start with checking to see if the function is even first. That means we find what is f of negative x. And we simplify this. So we have negative 4 times negative x cubed, which that equals positive 4x cubed. That does not equal f of x, so it's not even. But we have f of negative x. That's half the work that we need to check to see if the function is odd. So now let's do the other half of that work. Take the opposite of f of x. So we're going to take the opposite of the entire right-hand side of the function equation and simplify that. And we get positive 4x cubed. Well, that does equal f of negative x. So since f of negative x equals negative f of x, this is an odd function. Let's look at the graph. This is the graph of negative 4x cubed, and it does appear to have symmetry with respect to the origin. Every graph that does have symmetry with respect to the origin, or is called an odd function, must pass through the origin, and then every xy that's on the graph also has negative x, negative y on the graph, which this graph shows that symmetry. Let's do the other example now. Let's first see if it's even function. So we find h of negative x. Everywhere we see x, we plug in negative x, and then we simplify. So this will be 2x to the fourth minus x squared. And this equals h of x, so this function is even. Now, we don't have to continue and check to see if it's odd, because you cannot be both even and odd. You are either even, you are odd, or you're neither. So our work is done. Let's look at this graph. This graph is right here. Here's 2x to the fourth minus x squared. And as you can see, if you could fold this graph on the y-axis, it would map onto itself. So there is y-axis symmetry, and that's what we call an even function.